talking to myself and feeling old. Sometimes I'd like to quit, nothing ever seems to fit. Hanging around, nothing to do but frown. Rainy days and Mondays always get me down. What I've got they used to call the blues. Nothing is really wrong, feeling like I don't belong. Here with you, nice to know somebody loves me. Funny, but it seems that it's the only thing to do. Run and find the one who loves me. What I feel is come and gone before.
Joyland!
Headphones off.
She's coming round with the drinks again. You'll have to wait.
Can't wait.
He said he can't wait.
We only went 10 minutes ago.
Well, actually, Lil, he went into the airport and we've been in the air for over an hour or so.
Well, I'm stuck here. How am I supposed to get him out?
I'll get him out.
Yeah, all right, so I'll do it.
Come on, I'll do it. Leave it. Let go of it.
Come on. Come on, get up.
You all right, Dad?
Come on, get up.
1, 2, 3. Looking forward to visiting Malta then? I visit some of your old RAF haunts.
Yes, I'm right, looking forward to seeing you like in home. I was I'm breaking down.
It's good.
Okay,
Dad, that's a kick out.
You go all right?
Fine, man. Aim needs a bit of work, though.
You. I wanted to stop in duty-free.
We've got time for duty-free. It's going to take long enough to get you two through the bloody airport.
Yeah, well, that's your fault, isn't it, for not organising a wheelchair? Put your feet up, Jim. I need a patch.
You should have got some at Heathrow.
I couldn't see any. There was millions of fakes and no patches. If I don't find some soon, I'm going to have to get 20 king-size to tide me over.
Don't be ridiculous.
I'm serious, Nicholas. It's an addiction. It's a medical condition.
Like blocked arteries and angina. I've never heard anything so stupid in all my life.
All I know is that I'm gasping for a patch.
Look, why don't you two sit over here and watch the trolley, okay? And we'll go and pick up the car.
If you see any patches...
Yeah, I'll ignore them and walk right past one.
No.
Sit down, just keep your eye on the bags. We won't be long.
I'm really tired now.
So?
What? Do you think there's anyone back there?
Are you going to tell them?
Who?
Your mum and dad, about what the doctor said.
Oh, there's a chance I just step off the bloody plane.
1 minute, please take a seat. This is typical of you, this whole thing.
What?
You couldn't just tell them in London?
It's just sort of wait till we're on holiday, soften the blow.
Who for, you or them? She can't look after her much longer. You can see that. It's going to kill her.
Well, I know, but once we get to the villa and we're settled in, I can tell him then.
I'll make sure that you do. He needs to go into a home.
I know, I will.
It's a bit of a coincidence, though, isn't it? You bring them away the very week I happen to be ovulating.
You think I've done this to
me? I don't know what you did. But we finally agreed to try, and bingo. Next ovulation, you booked a holiday without me.
I didn't think you'd want to come.
Well, normally I wouldn't. But how are you going to get me pregnant from 1,000 miles away? It's big, Nick, but not that big.
So, you would like to hire a car, yes?
Yes, please.
Okay, then I will need your driving license, passport, and reservation number.
Well, actually, I haven't got a reservation.
Are you serious?
Is that a problem?
This is ridiculous. Are you sure they didn't have anything bigger?
Positive.
I'm getting pins and needles in the back here. How are you doing, Jim?
All right.
We can't spend a whole of the holiday in this thing.
Well, hopefully we're spending most of our time on the beach. Here, look down there. The sea looks nice, doesn't it?
Keep your eyes on the road.
Yes, I am watching the road.
It's all. Put that in my bag, will you, Laura? Oh, my God, Lil, what's all this?
Bloody hell, Mum. How much is in there?
None of your business.
That would be my business if you end up getting mugged. How much, Mum?
£4,645.
What? Oh, you're insane.
Well, I couldn't put it in the bank. I'll lose my rebate. And I ain't going to leave it in an empty house, am I?
Bloody unbelievable.
Stewing like sardines in a tin. There's no cause for driving angry, Nicholas. Not with your father in the car.
I am not driving angry.
Get your head up, Jim. Get it up! Oh.
Were they his teeth?
Yeah, look. I think they're on the floor behind you. Can you see them, Laura? Can you get them? Hey?
No, leave them.
No.
Will you please just leave them?
Don't look like the one in the brochure, Nick.
I know, because the one in the brochure wasn't available.
Well, I wish you told me.
What difference would it have made?
We might not have agreed to come if I'd have known. The other one had a bougainvillea.
Are you serious?
You've got us here under false pretenses. Look at them steps. Didn't you think about your father?
Of course I did. You know, that's why we're here. I know it's not ideal, but it'd be fine. What do you think, Dad? Lovely.
He's on medication. He don't know where he is half the time.
There's a pool next door.
Why didn't you get us the one with the pool?
Because it wasn't available.
Pool would have made up for the steps.
Fine. I'll call the agent first thing in the morning, see if she'll come around and dig you a pool. You happy?
Well, I suppose we'll just have to make the best of it, won't we? But I was expecting a bougainvillea. About this. I'm not raking over 40 years of history.
No
good can come of it. It's finished. Over with. Come on now, take your tablets. Open your mouth.
Is everything all right?
Oh, but yeah, fine. Dad's just been difficult about his pills. What do you think? Dinner out here tonight?
Yeah, okay.
Hi.
Hello. What are you doing?
I just thought that we could kill some time before dinner.
Laura, please, sorry, just, no. Sorry, Laura, it's just, no.
Come on, what's
it? Laura, it just feels a bit contrived.
What does?
This, you starting things. Laura, you're not even drunk.
I'm drunk? Why would I be drunk? You know what alcohol does to my ovulation cycle?
See? You're not actually horny. You're trying to get pregnant. It feels a bit fake.
This was the deal, Nick. You bring your parents away, I get sex 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
It's not very exciting or arousing. To be honest with you, I can't help thinking that you'd be just as happy with a syringe.
Well, in this showing, a syringe would be a massive bloody improvement. Do you want a baby or not?
Yes. It's been a long day, and I'm tired, and I'm worried about Mum and Dad.
Did you tell her yet? About the care home?
No, not yet. We haven't got time for this. Listen, Dad needs his dinner in half an hour. But maybe later, though, eh?
Sure, Nick, maybe later.
So, what do you want to start with tomorrow? Sightseeing or the beach?
Why do you want to go sightseeing with your dad the way he is?
See, Major. Just some of his old haunts. What do you reckon, Dad? What do you want to do?
Oh, Jim.
Look at this.
You stupid, obstinate old bugger. What do you want to go and bring that for? When your father was stationed in Malta, he got that woman pregnant.
Maria Spiteri.
Thing is, he didn't get the letter till 5 years after he left the RAF, and then we was 2 years married.
Army post.
And he tried to get in touch, but it was a long time afterwards, and she'd moved on. And you couldn't get a flight them days the way you can now, and then you was born, and that was that. Is that her? You devious sod. I never knew you had that.
Maybe you don't know everything.
Apparently not.
Bloody hell, Dad.
Can I? Wow, she's stunning. Then again, everyone looks better in black and white, don't they? It's true.
So what are you saying? Well, you want to try and find her?
He wants to find his son, that's what he's saying.
She had a son?
Anthony. It's all in the letter. I've told him that's not going to happen.
Why not?
Because. It's over 40 years ago, dragging up the past like that. It's not healthy.
This means I've got a brother.
Half-brother. Maybe. If that.
He's your son, yeah? Are you sure of that? You never told me. Bloody hell, Dad.
Some holiday this is turning out to be. I need a patch.
Sure you want to do this?
I don't know. But a man wants to find his son. It's got to be the right thing to do, isn't it?
Well, that's what you said about the home.
What? I don't think now's a good time. Maybe later, we'll see. You two all right?
Yeah. You sure you found all the Spiteries?
Trust me, they're not in the phone book.
This is ridiculous. An address from a 40-year-old letter is a bloody wild goose chase. We should be on the beach.
Oh, great.
Yeah, by the way, you're blocked in.
Wait here, I'll get next door to shift it.
While you're there, ask him if his surname's Spiteri.
Hello?
Is this back
enough? Yeah, it's back to 30. I worked down to Coconut Oil by the end of the week.
Hiya.
Hiya, you're blocking us in.
You Francesca? I meant Villa Francesca, where you're staying. Hey, we have some funny couples in there over the years, you know. We had this one fella, he spent the whole 2 weeks locked away like a hermit. Albino he was, pink eyes and everything, in this weather and all, eh? Mind you, changed good rest, didn't it? His wife was all right, like, yeah, drowned like a fish, mind.
We really need to...
Oh, it's Len, by the way. Oh, no, I won't check out this.
No, we really need to get going.
Oh, all right, sorry, I won't be a moment. I'll just go and fetch me flip-flops.
Now, that's a nice car. Look how roomy it is. Wouldn't have lost your teeth in one of them, would you, Jim?
See anything you recognise, Dad? It'll pull back loads of memories.
No, I won't get your hopes up too much, Nick. You've done here a couple of months.
What?
A couple of months? Bloody hell, are you serious?
What's the matter?
Well, it's just the way he talked about it. I thought he was here for years.
Of course he talks about it. He had a ruddy son here, didn't he?
Jesus, Dad, a couple of months, you don't hang about, do you? Where else were you stationed, eh? Any little Burmese brothers or sisters I should know about?
Nick.
How about some Belgians or maybe some Poles?
Nicholas, that's enough.
How about some Germans? Any Germans, eh, Dad?
Short one. I think this is a pointless bloody exercise because to expect somebody to be there 40 years later, you're a bloody idiot.
Well, you never know, do you?
Right, I'm going to do a left here, everybody.
How many times have we moved in the last 40 years?
Well, this is it.
Recognise it, Dad? Good, Dad. Hang on. Hello? Is your mum and dad in?
They're in bed.
We're looking for some people that used to live here. Maria Spiteri and her son Anthony.
Who is it?
Oh, good grief.
Sorry to disturb you. We're looking for Maria or Anthony Spiteri.
No, you have the wrong house, don't
you? They lived here maybe 40 years ago.
Is this some kind of joke?
No, they really did. Dad, don't do that. Dad.
I can't help you, sorry.
I know, Maria. They say she had this boy off an RAF mechanic when they were still stationed at Luha. After that, a boy from San Lorenz moved in. There were several others after that and all. Oh, aye. Maria was very popular, if you get my meaning.
And do you know where she is now?
Oh, she's dead. Must be over 30 years ago.
Oh, no. How sad.
So very young.
And her son, do you know what became of him?
Well, he went to the orphanage, St. Mary's, next to the church.
Maybe we could ask there.
They closed that down a long time ago. Although the boy was in the choir. Now, if you're looking for him, perhaps Father Joseph could help.
Would he be at the church?
No, he returned to Gozo. The Basilica Santa Maria. There's a ferry from Chiricahua, but you'll need a car.
What I don't understand is how you never realised that Jim was only here for 2 months.
Yeah, well, we never really talked much, did we, eh, Dad? Used to when I was little, but I sort of lost interest, didn't you, eh?
Well, that was the Parkinson's taking hold. I mean, it wasn't that bad at first, was it, Jim? But then he got depressed and he did lose interest in a lot of things.
Oh, yeah, like my glider. Never did get to build that one, did we? And then there was the Hornby and then the den. Always some excuse, wasn't it, eh, Dad?
Sounds familiar.
Yeah, well, maybe it wasn't a Parkinson's. Maybe it was just his bloody family.
Oh, don't be so daft. He don't know where he is half the time. It's the tablets. He comes and goes, don't you, mate?
I mean, what kind of a ferry doesn't have duty-free?
It's a local ferry. We're not leaving Maltese waters.
Yeah, but they shouldn't call it a ferry then, should they? Without duty-free, it's just a big boat.
What is it, Lil? Is this about your patches?
Yeah. I left them on Mrs. What's-her-name's sofa, didn't I? Typical. Remember, this medication left my own behind.
It's all right. I picked them up as we left.
Why don't you say anything?
I thought I might have wean you off.
Wean me? I was just about to buy 60 bloody king size. Look at me. God knows what my blood pressure's like.
She does have a point.
I tell you what, Lil, why don't you and Nick just sit here and take in the view and I'll take Jim for a walk around the deck?
What?
What do you reckon, Jim? Do you fancy a walk, eh?
Yes.
Yeah, lovely, Laura. Oh, if he wants to go to the toilet, bring him straight back. He hasn't been for a couple of hours.
It's nice, isn't it, Mum?
Bit of a change from Bromley.
Yeah, well, you think this is nice, maybe you should have gone on that cruise with Sylvia.
It would have been nice. Couldn't leave your dad behind.
Dad had been for a week.
In a care home. Couldn't do that to him.
The thing is, Mum, the time's coming when you won't be able to look after Dad the way you have been. Everyone can see it. You know, things ain't been easy for you.
It's getting worse, son. I get so tired sometimes.
Well, and your health isn't what it used to be. I mean, not since your turn.
It was a heart attack. Nicholas, call me by his name.
Anyway, Mum, me and Laura have been thinking, and we don't think that Dad's care should be solely down to you.
Oh, Nick. I mean, I can't say it hasn't crossed my mind. I know it's what we always talked about, but since she was married, it hasn't come up, and... Are you sure Laura won't mind?
Laura?
Well, yeah. I mean, if me and your dad are going to move in with you, it's going to have a big impact on her life, isn't it?
Yeah, well, we haven't actually, we haven't sorted out the finer details yet. It's just an idea.
You talk to Laura in your own good time.
You didn't tell her?
I tried, but it's complicated.
Well, stalling's only going to make matters worse.
Yeah, well, I'm painfully aware of that.
False alarm.
I'll tell her tomorrow, I promise.
You bloody better.
There you go. Mind your head. And your legs. 1, 2, 3. There you are.
Nick.
What's that?
That's your dad's teeth. At least that way we know where they are. You're a good son.
Toilet!
Can you see them?
No, they've disappeared behind a bush.
How long do you think we have?
That's difficult to say. 5, 10 minutes, why? Oh, what are you doing?
Come on, let's do it.
What, Neil?
Why not? Quick, dirty monkey sex in that field over there.
Are you serious?
It'll be exciting, that's what you want, isn't it?
What if they come back and we're not here?
Okay, we'll just call over the bush and tell them we won't be loud.
No, I'll just be thinking about them.
Are you avoiding having sex with me?
No.
This is serious, Nick. I want a child.
Look, I know you do. I know, and so do I.
I need loo roll.
What?
It's number 2s, and I need loo roll.
Well, I haven't got any loo roll.
I told you to bring some to the bathroom.
No, you didn't.
I'm not going to stand here and argue with you, Nick, while your father's crouched behind a Maltese bush. What am I going to use?
I don't know. Won't you use the grass, the leaves or something?
Don't be ridiculous. It's the 21st century, not a bloody Stone Age. Well, rip a couple of pages out of the guidebook.
Well, I'm not sure that's a good idea, because the pages have a kind of glossy finish. And...
But it can't be chosen. Where is it? It's not in my bag.
Well, I thought you had it last night.
No, I'm trying.
I don't have it.
Laura, you had it.
You had it last.
No, I didn't.
I don't have that there.
Oh, no. I was on the floor.
So give me Gozo.
Hold on.
No,
Laura, excuse me, could you look down the
side? No, it's not down the side. Just look, you're not under your bed. Don't check under your bed.
No, not
under your
bed. No, it's stuck in. Put it away, quick, before the birds start pecking at it. Street.
What do
you reckon, Jim?
No.
Well, you must be blind, because it's exactly the same.
No. Stop being so difficult.
No.
Come on.
See what I have to put up with?
I can't leave you in the car all day, can I? Put your head down. Come on.
For many, the shrine at the Basilica is a place of pilgrimage and miracles. People visit from all over the world to ask for the intercession of Our Lady.
There you go, Jim. Make a wish if you want.
Yeah, although I think the technical term is praying.
I think there'd be more vicars about, wouldn't you?
Mum, it's a Roman Catholic church. They're not vicars, they're priests.
Same difference. All men in frocks, isn't it? Just a shrine. It was more like a surgical appliance shop.
These are the votive offerings of those cured through the intercession of the Virgin. Evidence of miracles, basically.
Excuse me, Father?
Yes?
I'm sorry, I'm looking for Father Joseph.
Father Joseph, may I ask why?
I'm looking for my brother, well, half-brother, and I was told Father Joseph might know him from the orphanage in Valletta. You see, it's my dad, he's not too well, and he'd like to meet his son before it's too late.
Father Joseph is also very sick. He has had a stroke, and his mind is not what it was.
Oh, well, I'm sorry to hear that, but if there's the slightest chance he might be able to help...
Here, give me your number. I'm visiting tomorrow. He's at the hospice of the Sisters of Mercy, just outside Bujimba. And I'll call you back with the time.
Thank you very much. That's very good of you. It's a UK mobile. I'm not sure what the code is.
It's okay.
It's something 44 and then you knock off the...
It's fine. I know
zero.
It.
Zero. Thank you very much. Well, I'm Nick, by the way.
Nick. Father Anthony.
Anthony? Well, that's my brother's name.
But there are many Antonys in Malta.
Oh, just, yeah, just saying.
Well,
Well, I told him what I wished for.
Prayed for?
I wish for him to get better. Completely better. And I do. I wish it every day. Make my life a damn sight easier, that's for sure.
Mum, if Dad doesn't want to tell you, he doesn't have to.
It's ridiculous. He's worried that if he tells me, it won't come true.
Do you know what I prayed for, Nick?
It's not like candles on a birthday cake. It's a Virgin Bloody Mary, you stupid sod. And you can put them away.
Mum, will you just leave it?
But since when have we had secrets, eh? Since when have this family had secrets from one another?
How about the last 40 years?
Apart from that. See? Never.
Hello?
I can hear a rattle. It's the engine, Nick. Can you hear a rattle?
Relax, Mum. It's nothing. It just needs a service.
A bit like your wife, eh, Nick?
Hello, Nick. I'm afraid Father Joseph has passed away.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
But it's a release. The doctors say it is unlikely he would ever have recovered his mental faculties, so...
Was you his wife?
He's a Catholic priest, Mum. They don't get married.
Mrs. Mazzini was Father Joseph's housekeeper for nearly 40 years.
I should never have let them bring him here. He should have died at home.
You did what you thought was best.
He looked so confused, so frightened.
It's the strange surroundings, isn't it?
I had been here for almost 3 months.
Yeah. Damn sight more comforting to die in your own bed, though, isn't it?
Well, that's true, Lil, but at least here you get the best care.
Care? And... there's no way to die. Tubes hanging out your nose and peeing into a bag. Where's the dignity in that?
Listen, Mum, come on, let's go, yeah? I'll take that.
Come on.
I'm sorry.
Nick, what is your brother's name? His full name?
Anthony Spiteri.
Ah, sorry, I thought perhaps on the off chance.
Oh, so. Well, thank you anyway.
Yeah, God be with you.
Dad. Dad, come on. Dad, let's go.
Hello there. Where have you been?
Hospice.
She's gone to Medina. Silent city. I love it there, I do. There's no lights at night, you know. Dead dark.
Keep telling them they got arrested. He will, you know, stalking them streets at night.
I'm just sucking up the atmosphere. Oh. Sorry, have you met my wife, Barbara?
Hiya.
Hello, Barbara. Oh, excuse me. Hello?
Nick, it's Father Anthony. I have some news about your brother.
Hey, it's about Anthony.
Yes, Mrs. Mazzini said he came to see Father Joseph just last week.
Anthony's visited Father Joseph. Well, that's fantastic news.
Yes, she thinks he was working on this building site, the Hillview Apartments in Tarshin.
Yeah, well, that's fine, because I can go to the site and ask around.
No, that may not be necessary. I have an address right here. Do you have a pen?
Oh, give me a sec. I think we found Anthony.
Don't say he lives around here. Look at it.
What do you expect? He was in an orphanage at the age of 10. Didn't exactly have a head start in life, did he? Oh, right. No, we're here. That's right, we go. Yeah, get up there, I'll have
a
Oh my God, it's massive.
Look at my head.
Jim, he's got a boat. And look at that car and that Jeep.
How do I look?
Fine.
Just fine?
Lovely. How do I look?
You know that top's never been to my taste.
Looks like he's out.
I can hear music.
Yeah, it's coming from round the back.
What do you want?
I'm sorry, we rang the bell, but no one
else. Get out, go on. You are not welcome.
We're looking for Anthony Spiteri. Son of Maria Spiteri.
Why, who wants him?
Why, are you Anthony?
Tell me who you are first. Then perhaps I'll fetch him.
Well, this is my father. He was stationed at Lucca in the late 50s with the RAF. Then he had an affair with a lady called Maria Spiteri. And when he went back to England, she had a child, a son. And, well, she sent him this photograph. And this.
Anthony, we did try and get in touch, but by the time the letter came, it was no use. We had nothing to go on.
So, Nick, you are his son too?
Yes.
Then you are my brother.
Yeah, well, half-brother.
I never had a brother before.
Well, that makes two of us.
My little brother, Nicky. And you must be my sister.
Oh, I'm Laura, Nick's wife.
Oh, well, that's a relief, because to be this attracted to my own sister would be illegal.
Okay, plus a little sick.
Exactly, which is why it's illegal. So you are my sister-in-law?
Yeah.
You have a beautiful wife, Nick.
Thank you. So you keep saying.
So, Anthony, what about you? Is there a lady in your life?
No, work is my mistress.
Well, judging by this place, I can't say I blame you. Hey, Nick? Done all right for himself, isn't he?
Absolutely.
By rights, it should be you with the flash cars and swanky villa.
Oh, forgive me, Dad. You don't have a drink. Maybe you'd like a beer.
No. Not with his tablets. You may have noticed your dad's not a well man.
He's got Parkinson's.
Like the poor pen.
Exactly. Not the shaking kind, thank God.
Is it genetic?
No.
So, how long are you in Malta for?
5 more days.
Oh, so little time. In that case, we must spend it together. I show you everything. I show you a real Maltese festa.
Oh, we don't want to put you to any trouble.
It's not trouble. We can start tomorrow.
Well, that's great, isn't it, Jim? Isn't it, Nick? Dad would love that. Did you see him, Laura? See Jim crying when they met? Tears streaming down his face. Never seen that before, eh, Nick?
No, never. Can't remember the last time you hugged anyone either.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Couldn't be better.
Recognize it, Dad?
Yes.
That's great. Perhaps you came with my mother.
Yes.
This was her favorite beach.
Nice spot. Lovely. Come on, Nick, aren't you going to get changed?
Dora, will you just give us a chance? We're supposed to be on holiday, aren't we?
Seen anyone apply sun cream like that before.
In that case, perhaps you would like.
Well, if you wouldn't mind.
Well, no, it's all right, because I can do that.
All right, Nick. Anthony's got it. Oh, hang on, sorry.
Yeah.
You've gone all red.
Oh, shit.
Mum, where's Laura and Entley?
Oh, they've gone for a swim. They've gone ages.
Hello again.
Oh, hi.
You're not swimming?
No, I'm just watching my wife and a friend.
Oh, you mean Anthony?
You know him?
Oh, your wife introduced us. Incredible swimmer. He raced me that rocky out there, thrashed me pants off. Nice bloke, though. Very knowledgeable. Yeah, we had a nice chat sitting on that rock while I recovered. Oh, aye, aye. Time for a top-up of the olfactor 20. Deceptively high chalk content in this sand.
Talking about, of course he's Anthony Spiteri, bloody clown.
All I'm saying is he seems to have taken to Dad a little too easily.
Oh, Nick.
Oh, let's face it, Dad's not the most welcoming of characters. No offence, Dad, I know it's not used to Parkinson's. But on top of all that, he's never seen the man in 40 years. Next thing you know, he's hugging him, kissing him, massaging his back. I'm sorry, it's too much.
Too much for you, perhaps.
And we haven't seen his ID. How can we be sure he is who he says he is?
Because we're the ones who traced him.
No, Mum, it was some priest who told us where he lived. And how do we know he was a priest?
What kind of conspiracy is this? A bogus priest, dodgy old ladies, and a fake Anthony Spiteri? What possible reason could he have to pretend to be your father's son?
Now, come on, Nick, it's understandable you'd be a little jealous.
What?
Well, you've been an only child all these years, and now suddenly you have a brother.
Laura, please, spare me the tabloid psychology. If he's so rich, what's he doing working on the building site? That's what the priest said.
Oh, so now he is a priest. I thought he was part of the international conspiracy.
Probably got it wrong. He was only passing on what he was told.
Forget it, I'm going to bed.
You okay?
Sorry?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Good.
Sunburn.
All right, Nick, what the hell is going on?
Nothing. You know, Laura, it really hurts.
You are avoiding having sex with me.
No, I'm not.
I knew it, you bastard.
The beach has deceptively high chalk content.
What?
It's worse than it looks.
Do you want to have sex with me, yes or no?
Of course. Let me go and get a drink first. I'm just feeling a little bit dehydrated.
How's that?
It's better, thanks. Laura, please. Can we leave that till tomorrow? You know, what with my sunburn and now my foot.
Are you serious? Are you absolutely fucking serious?
Well, the mood's kind of gone now.
Well, maybe tomorrow. That's all I ever get from you. And I don't just mean sex. You still haven't told your mother.
Well, I'm going to tell her after the festa.
Oh, bollocks, Nick. Bollocks. What is your problem?
I don't have a problem.
You never do anything.
Yes, I do.
Well, you don't act like it. Anthony wouldn't have a problem telling your mother about the care home. He wouldn't have a problem getting me knocked up either.
Afternoon. What's your plans for tonight then?
Oh, we're going to the festa.
Oh, I love the festa and all the brass band, fireworks, all the dancing. Gets me all excited. I can feel the sap rising. I can't wait to get Babs back to the boudoir for a good old bashing.
Leonard.
Well, it's true.
Landing in the middle of the people. No more than 2 meters from my mother. Just a little girl with the pigtails. And everyone waited for the explosion. But it did not explode. Praise be to God.
Oh my God.
What exactly is it you do?
For work, I'm a wheeler dealer. I buy things and sell them for more. It's very boring.
What kind of things?
Mainly real estate.
That's a coincidence, because Nick's an estate agent.
Oh, really? So, you know, I buy and sell land. Sometimes I develop it.
Like the apartments you were working on.
Exactly. Once the builder finishes, I sell them off. But enough of that. I want to know, Laura, when you and Nick plan to have children.
Yeah, good question. We've been wondering that, haven't we, Jim?
Nick isn't ready for children yet.
Actually, Laura, that ain't quite true.
Really?
In that case, Nikki, I suggest you hurry up before some other man comes along. There must be many who would be only too pleased. Oh. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
Now, we have some fun. Lil, let's have a dance.
Oh, no.
Come on, it's a festa.
I'll fucker it all, man.
What a scene for the bar. Rajt mil-bot il-delta swar Ksib li taħtom tistennini Em imħabba tar minnar Rajt id-dwar tal-belt valletta Min għalija sib dislin Mal imħabba daħet bija Flok il-bidu sib titmim Inzilt maħa strada stretta
Ada, let's go dance.
No, Daddy, can't.
Why not?
Well, you'll feel it in the morning.
There is no such thing as pleasure without consequence. Right, Dad?
Valletta,
pair dance with my brother's wife?
Sure, why not? Help yourself.
What are we going to do now? Just that my dad needs to get home.
We have to find a taxi. We must go back in that way, sorry. Successful in a small place like Malta. Many people are jealous. Many people expect you to pay for what is yours by right.
What? So you gave me a car?
It's only money. In Malta, no matter how difficult the problem, the answer is always the same. I'm sure it's like this in your country. How's your face?
Numb. I'm guessing that's a bad thing.
Have you noticed? The same nose.
Dad's nose.
Dad's nose.
Nick! Nick!
Mom! Laura!
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, Nick. Have you seen your dad?
I thought he was with you.
He's gone in the crowd. We've lost him.
Dad. Dad.
Dad. You all right?
Tell me, why did you bring him here? You didn't know about me. So what did you think he would get from this?
Man deserved one last holiday. I thought I should give him that.
Yes, obligations, responsibilities. Yet, Laura thinks you brought him here to avoid these things.
Laura? You always got nothing to do with you. You've only just met the man.
This is true. I'm the son with no responsibilities. No obligations. Perhaps I'm the son you wish you could be.
You're wrong. Dad. Dad, come on, let's get you home, Dad. Come on. Come on, Dad.
Jim, you have to take these. Come on, open your mouth. Don't make me hold your nose.
Okay.
Yeah, it's been a bit difficult. I think the events of last night upset him a bit. Right, that's it. How's your eye?
No, it's fine. It's only sore if I touch it.
It's a bit like your foot then. And your sunburn.
Stupid bloody man, eat it. Eat the fucking thing! Take it, sonny! You might think I'm a monster. I've never done that before, you know that, don't you? Well, sometimes I just snap. If he doesn't take his medication, it can be weeks before he's straight again, and that's when I'm most alone. It's as if he's gone, and then I panic, because I think I might never get him back again.
No.
Sorry, mate. I'm so sorry, Jim. I'm sorry. You scare the hell out of me sometimes. It's getting worse. And he's getting worse quicker. I see it every day. Sometimes I think it might just be kinder if one day you didn't wake up.
Mum, me and Laura have been talking. and we might have a solution.
Thank God. Thank you, Laura. Ever since Nick mentioned it, I haven't been able to think of anything else.
No, I actually...
I mean, we can sell the house now, and we can chip in with your mortgage, and that works out for everybody.
I'm sorry, Lil, but what are we talking about here?
About me and Jim moving in with you two.
That's not what Nick is saying.
No, it's what he suggested on the ferry.
No, I didn't actually suggest it.
You're unbelievable. I'm sorry. No.
What?
Mum, Dad needs professional care.
A nursing home? Well, you can stuff that. He's never going near one of them places.
Mum, Dr. Denton told me if you don't ease up, you're going to end up killing yourself.
That's my lookout.
And then what? Dad winds up in a nursing home without you coming to see him. Do you think that's what he really wants, do you?
How do you know what he wants? Have you asked him?
Fine. What do you want, eh, Dad? Do you want to live with Mum and drive her to an early grave? Eh? Is that what you prayed for at the church? Or do you want to live in a care home? What about that, eh? Or maybe you'd rather come and live with me and Laura?
That's not an option.
Dad, just please, just tell us what you want.
Toilet.
Come on, mate. I'll take you. And don't worry. I won't put you in a home. I'll never do that to you.
How is my brother today?
All right.
Your eye isn't so bad. You should see my ribs. Are they ready?
Who?
Mum and Dad. I was going to take them out.
In a jeep?
Why not?
Well, do you think it's safe for Dad?
Since when did you start caring about your father's welfare?
All right, hang on, I'll come with you.
Like hell you will. I think it's best if we spend a bit of time apart, don't you? Besides, it'll give you and Laura an afternoon to yourselves. Seeing as you find us such unwelcome company.
I just keep coming back to the same question. What's the point in being married if we're not going to have kids? What's the point in us if we're not going to be a family?
The laughs? Okay, I'm sorry. But I do want a family, Laura. I told you that.
Yeah, well, maybe you think you do, but... actions speak louder than words, Nick, and when it comes to it, for whatever reason, you just... you're scared.
Be honest. Do you look at my family and see a resounding success? Let's face it, I'm not a good son. Especially with my dad and his illness.
Well, there's only so much you can do. You can't cure him of Parkinson's.
I just try to put him in a home.
Does that make you a bad son, Nick? You'd be a great father.
Really? Can you really be sure of that?
Thing is, Nick, I want kids. And unless You do too. We don't have a future.
All right.
No. Just leave me, all right? Just leave me.
Bye, Mum. Bye, Dad.
See you tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
Come on, Jim.
Hi, Nick.
So, good day.
Yeah, very nice, thank you.
Where did you go?
Oh, you know, even there. Oh, your dad brought some back for you.
Oh, yeah?
It was in this little craft shop. And he saw the bloody thing lit up, went crazy. Never seen anything like it. Right, Jim?
Easy to build a three-foot model, wings by 1,000 metres. Seems fairly straightforward. Get out of bed. Quite a lot of pieces, Dad.
Say, Mum, sit down, will you?
It was coming here at 10. He's never been late before.
We're only going to the beach. What are you getting so worked up for?
Who's getting worked up?
Where is it? Where is the little fucker?
Who?
Who'd you bloody think? That Anthony, that's who.
What are you on about?
8,000 quid, mate. 8,000 quid of our bloody money.
Anthony has sold us a timeshare on a flat.
We've just been round there, so have a look. There's a couple living in it with a baby. Bold as you like, they've just moved in.
It's not a timeshare at all. It's residential.
£8,000 we gave him. £8,000 of our money in cash and traveller's cheques. He's completely cleaned us out, and that was the last of my redundancy pay, that was. What are we supposed to do now, eh? You tell me.
Oh, come on, calm down.
Jesus.
Oh.
No, Mum, I'm telling you didn't.
Yes. He must have taken us all to the same place. Beautiful it was. All tiles. Lovely and easy to clean.
How much did you give him?
We thought it'd be nice to come back every year and maybe if your dad couldn't manage it, you and Laura could come on your own.
How much, Mum?
What was in my handbag, plus the money out of Dad's wallet and the money in the bag, in the wardrobe, and £7,000.
What? There was only £4,000 in that hold-all.
Well, like I said, it was what I had in my handbag as well.
For a non-existent timeshare?
It was for 2 weeks. I can't believe he'd do this to us. Especially not your dad. His own flesh and blood.
Oh, wake up, Mum. He's no one's flesh and blood. He's a bloody con man. I told you he was.
Where's the police?
No, what? Just hang on. Hang on. If you do that, it could be months before you see the money again. If ever. Let me see if I can find him.
What makes you think you can find him? He's not going to hang about, is he?
Well, even more reason not to waste time at a police station.
Fine, we'll try it. But I'm going with you.
What?
Oh, for all we know, they could be in on it. Gypsy con artists working their med. I'm coming with you, and Barbara, you're staying here. Make sure this lot don't do a runner.
Right.
You are joking, aren't you? I'm not getting in that thing.
Why not?
It's a death trap. We'll take the MPV.
Unless you put your foot down, we're going to miss him.
Already doing 5 miles an hour over the limit. These shrines at the curbside, not for decoration, you know. They let people have died.
Go on, you can make that. Go on, go for it. You can make that. Where are you playing it?
God, don't play dice, neither do I.
Right, that's it.
Hey, what are you doing? Where are you going? He's doing a bloody runner. What are you playing at? Get in!
What are you doing, you mad bastard? I'm not covered for this. I can wait, you'll come with me, it's up to you.
Anthony! Where's his jeep?
He's gone.
So what now then?
I've got an idea.
Slow down, you mad bastard!
Picked up his wages about an hour ago. He's catching a ferry to Sicily.
No, he's too close. Come on.
All right.
That's just gratuitous, that. There's no need for it. Oh, yeah, nice parking. That's him! There he is! Stop! Stop that man! I'm sorry, sir, I need to see a lot. I haven't got my passport, I've got that bloke dead. Get off there, I haven't got anything. He's the one who should be grabbing, he's a thief. Stop! Hey, your nipple, you've got me nipple. Yes, yes. Stop it, get off.
Anthony.
Hey, Nick. How nice to see you.
I've come for the money, you bastard.
You can't at least be civilized. We are brothers, after all.
Parks, just give me the money.
You don't think we are brothers?
Of course I don't.
You think I chose this? You think I'm not ashamed to steal from the one man I've waited all my life to meet? I owe money in Sicily.
It's not like the bank.
They don't exactly send you letters.
So that's what the car was about.
Yes. Although that wasn't actually mine. Nor is the jeep or the villa. An old friend has no wife for himself. Sometimes I house it. So you see, it was not personal. Plus, until now, my father has given me nothing. Surely, I deserve something. Bye, Nick.
Bye. That's from me. I'll make up the difference. So, how much of what you told us was the truth then?
I'm your brother. The rest was some truth, some lies, mostly lies. I have a little girl back in Sicily, and a woman, the girl's mother. Who won't marry me yet, but she will.
What's her name?
My daughter, Felicia. And the pig-headed woman is Gabriella. So, what will happen to our father?
I don't know. I don't know what the right thing is to do.
Sometimes there is no right things. Sometimes there are only bad choices. If all you have are bad choices, choosing one doesn't make you a bad person. Goodbye, my brother. I wish you a wonderful life and beautiful children and the whole you have dreamed of.
If he was in so much trouble, all he had to do was ask. We'd have lent him the money, wouldn't we, Jim? Didn't have to steal. I hope he'd be all right without it.
I'm sorry, Dad. Don't be. I'm not.
So how does it feel to be a hero?
Hurts.
Good.
Let's do it.
You mean?
Dirty monkey sex.
You realize I'm at the absolute peak of my fertility?
Good, me too.
And you're not worried?
No, something Anthony said. Maybe I'm not a bad son. I'm just the best son I can be. And I'll be the best dad I can be. What more can I do? But like an adventure.
And you like adventures?
I think I do, yeah.
Are they all right?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, what happens when we get home?
Who knows?
Toilet! I'm sorry.
Don't be daft. Stand in there a second. Hey, Dad? What do you reckon?
Enjoying yourselves for once. What's the water like?
It's lovely. Fancy paddle, Dad?
Yeah, why not? What do you say, Jim?
Yes. One, two, three.
That's all I got you. Well, there you go.
No. Let me go. Please. I wish.